Christianity and Islam. I think we would rather have it as Judaism, Christianity and Islam. Because there is a definite affinity between these three great Semitic faiths. See, the religions of the world can easily be divided into two major groups. One group of religions called the Aryan religions, and the other group of religions, the Semitic religions. Among the Aryan religions, I would consider Hinduism, Buddhism, and Zoroastrianism. This is of the Aryan group. The Semitic, Judaism, Christianity, and Islam. The unity of these three faiths consists in the unity of God. You see, in the fundamentals of the teachings of Moses, Jesus, and Muhammad, may the peace of God be upon them all, there is not an iota of difference. I said in the fundamentals of the teachings of Moses, Jesus, and Muhammad. I didn't say in the teachings of Judaism, Christianity, and Islam. Mark my words. Now, in the fundamentals of the teachings of these prophets, I said there is not an iota of difference. Between the religious groupings, there are many differences. When I say there is no difference in the fundamentals, I mean, like, for example, the first commandment. The very first commandment, as given by God Almighty to the holy prophet Moses, was in the Hebrew language, Shama Israel Adonai Eloheinu Adonai Echad, which means, Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. The first commandment. Some 1350 years after Moses, a learned man of the Jews called a scribe in the Gospel of St. Mark, chapter 12, verse 29, this learned man of the Jews comes to Jesus and questions him. He said, Master, in the Hebrew language, Rabbi, Maulana, learned man, Sheikh, Master, what commandment is the first of all? And Jesus answers and says unto him, in the Hebrew language, Shama Israel Adonai Eloheinu Adonai Echad. Hear, O Israel, the Lord, our God, the Lord is one. He repeated word for word what was given by Moses 1300 years before, without the change of a dot. That in the fundamentals of religion, in the fundamentals of belief or faith, there is no change. He confirms the very words given by Moses. Some 600 years after Jesus, a Christian deputation comes to the holy prophet Muhammad in Medina. And they were having a dialogue for 3 days and three nights in the Masjid al-Nabawi, the mosque of the Prophet. Mosque for 3 days and three nights. During the course of this discussion, this dialogue, the spokesman for the Christian poses the question. He said, all right, now tell us, O Muhammad, among so many other things, says, tell us now, what is your concept of God? And the holy prophet Muhammad is made to say, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ Say, He is God, the one and only. He said, أَحَدْ, one and only. Jesus said, إِخَدْ, meaning one and only. Moses said, إِخَدْ, meaning one and only. What is the difference? It's the same word meaning the same thing. أَحَدْ and إِخَدْ. أَحَدْ in Hebrew, in Arabic means one. إِخَدْ in Hebrew means one. And the difference between these two words is only the pronunciation. I would write Ahad, Alif, Ha, Da, Ahad in Arabic, meaning one and only. And to make it Ihad, on the Ha I put a dot, that becomes Ha. Ha becomes Ha just by putting a dot. That is in the writing, calligraphy. But as far as the meaning is concerned, the word is concerned, it means one and the same thing. That God Almighty is the one and only being that there is. So, my statement that in the fundamentals of the teachings of Moses, Jesus, and Muhammad, there is not an iota of difference.